Hey, what's going on, guys? I'm Chris, and this is Regular Guy Training. So, I had a couple of minutes here, and I get a lot of questions about this, so I figured I'd talk about it. A lot of times people ask me, you know, hey, well, obviously you're a fan of putting dots on handguns and that kind of thing. Obviously, that's your way, right? So, like, how do I get into zeroing it? What's a good distance? Because I'm hearing a couple of different things. What should I use? Blah, 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 right? So, there's actually a couple of really good ways to A, make sure that you're on paper, and then two, the actual distance itself. Now, what you ultimately want more than anything else is a point of aim, point of impact zero at 25 yards. And the reason for that is once you have point of aim, point of impact at 25 yards, you're pretty much point of aim, point of impact out to 100. Now, especially for like concealed handgun and that kind of stuff. I mean, like that pretty much covers the gambit as far as like what you would need, you know, from zero to a football field is pretty much what you would need. And the funny thing is if you have to go even further than that, the holdovers are very easy, like very easy once you have that particular zero. So that's the zero that I would personally recommend is, you know, make sure that you have a point of aim, point of impact at 25, and then just kind of go from there. But there's, you know, especially for people that are brand new to dots on handguns or get their first one and they're trying to figure out exactly how to zero this thing, sometimes people get frustrated because when they start, you know, they start getting impacts off paper and they don't know what to do. So one of the best ways to figure this one out is, you know, you take your handgun and you recognize that there is about an inch and a half of distance from here to here, meaning height of your sights to your bore. So what you do is you go to about 3 yards. You go to about 3 yards, and once you get to about 3 yards, okay, you hold on a particular point, right? And if your zero is close, you know, or good, it's going to impact an inch and a half low of what you're holding that dot on. Okay, so no left and right jazz and an inch and a half low. That's pretty much where you want to be at 3. And I mean, inch and a half really is like joint from the joint to the tip of your thumb, right? So you can figure that one out pretty easily. As far as up close stuff and that kind of deal, there isn't any really crazy holdovers or anything like that. But the height over bore will exist because you have an optic floating on top of your slide, right? So you have an inch and a half an inch and a half low point of impact versus your point of aim, which is very easy to figure out. But once you've made your giant adjustments at 3 and, you know, you have your point of impact exactly an inch and a half low beneath the thing that you're shooting at, then you can go ahead back up to 25, you know, brace up on a bag or whatever it is that you need, and then you can do your point of aim, point of impact at 25, right? Once you're zeroed, I mean, it really shouldn't be all that difficult. The 3-yard deal, though, I would only, this kind of requires you individually to like shoot good, right? So, you know, if you really, really have to, and if you can't get on paper at 25, bench up at 3 and then do that, because it requires you to like impact, you know, bullet holes on top of each other at 3. And, you know, contrary to what a lot of fucking keyboard warriors and that kind of stuff will say in the comments section, a lot of people just don't shoot that well with handgun. That's just how it goes. But, you know, if that's your bag, if that's what you want to do, okay, cool. Because me personally, I'm never going to stop somebody from using a red dot and a handgun pretty much at any stage of their training life or anything like that. Because you see things through a dot that you never would through a set of irons anyway. So I don't really see a point in time that is like bad for someone to come in on red dots as far as handguns go. And there's a lot of people that don't train, that don't shoot very much, or took a class one time forever ago, that'll disagree with this. But, I mean, they're all pretty slow and bad anyway, so it doesn't really matter. So, point is, though, is that, you know, if that's where you want to be as far as your zeros and that kind of stuff. I mean, there's other zeros out there for sure, but the one that I'm just gonna stay at is point of aim, point of impact at 25 and just kind of go from there. So, you know, that's just my personal opinions on what zero you should use, a couple of good ways to get into said zero. You know, if you have any other additional questions, you can throw that in the comment section below. If you have need of training, we have classes coming up for sure. Especially in the Georgia and Florida area. We're getting ready to do both of those fairly soon. We are also doing another mechanical series in Drakesboro, Kentucky. So if you want to come out there and do that, you can do that. You know, no problem. Just check us out. You know, link in the description below for our website. If you want to check us out on Facebook, you absolutely can. Again, all the links for this kind of stuff will be in the description below. If you want to check us out and support us through Patreon, that helps a great deal as far as just keeping everything afloat, making sure that everything is consistent for us. And if you want to get something out of it too, $41 a month ensures that you can get as much training that you want with us as you can handle. So, and it doesn't matter where it is or what it is, except for our vehicle classes, everything else is covered. So if you pay $41 a month, you can come out and train with us as much as you like. And a lot of guys have abused the absolute shit out of that system. You know, that and it greatly helps me out. So all that said, guys, I hope that was a little bit helpful. For one reason or another, a lot of people have asked me, what my thought process was on that as far as dots on handguns, where I should zero and blah, blah, blah. So I figured I'd go ahead and give you a what for and why is on that whole subject. And I appreciate all of the patriotism, especially with recent happenings, because there's a lot of really stupid crap happening right now, and you guys have been coming out in droves shutting down fucking morons that are constantly just kind of sitting there like, we're doomed, there's nothing we can do, because really I'm just a lazy little fag and I'm not going to do any of the work myself. So, like, I really appreciate the guys coming out and shutting that nonsense down and just kind of pushing forward with everything that's needed to happen over the last few months, right? So, you guys keep it real with these people and keep on telling them, you know, stop developing excuses, develop solutions, you idiots, because a shooting war is not what you want, you stupid bastard. So, you know, it is what it is at that point. But I'm going to jump off that soapbox. I'm going to leave all this stupid crap alone because you guys already know. But that said, remember, regular guys' firearm is the last defense against tyranny. Be easy.